إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ثم أما بعد. As I'm sure we're all aware of the events that happened just a week ago, we are all reeling and we're still experiencing heartache. And it is important that we recognize and come to terms with the fact that the way we feel is very natural. This is how Allah Azza wa Jalla has created us. It is very natural for us to feel fear. It is very natural for us to fear, to feel even anger. It is very natural. And some of us might even be in a state of shock. As we know from the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, that he relays to us that after the events of Ta'if, as you're aware, the children were stoning the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam until his feet were bleeding. And the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam says that he kept walking until a mile later he found himself in this one place. He says, he quite literally says, almost in astonishment, that I simply found myself in this place. As in to say, this past mile, he wasn't very cognizant of what he was doing. And modern psychologists would call this a state of shock. This, what the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam may have been experiencing is quite literally a state of shock where his systems literally shut down and he's not really sure what's going on and he just kind of reawakens a mile later. So it is very natural for us to be feeling like this. It is also very natural for us to have questions. Questions like, why? Why, Ya Allah? Why, Ya Allah, would you allow something like this to happen? Even the malaika, subhanallah, Allah Azza wa Jalla, these malaika that can do no wrong. When faced with such grim realities, even the malaika ask, they ask Allah Azza wa Jalla, Allah Azza wa Jalla reveal to them that He will be creating us in Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءَ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ. That Allah Azza wa Jalla has revealed to the angels that He will be creating us as vicegerents in this dunya. And so the malaika, they question those species, this creature that Allah Azza wa Jalla has created that can do no wrong. Even they are asking Allah Azza wa Jalla, would you create something? What is the purpose behind creating something that could shed blood like this? And what we see is, while the question is natural, and it is mentioned in a very respectful way, and the question itself is valid, Allah Azza wa Jalla responds in the most beautiful, elegant, and simple ways. Allah Azza wa Jalla, what does He say? I know what you do not. I know what you do not. And this is where our faith kicks in. This is literally the whole doing of our faith. That we believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, and we believe in the fact that Allah Azza wa Jal knows what He is doing. Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't do anything abatha, just cuz, randomly. Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't just do things out of chaos. There is a plan, there is a reason behind everything, there is a purpose behind every single act that Allah Azza wa Jal puts forth in this dunya. And so that is the crux of our faith. It is literally called faith because it is a matter of belief. We believe that Allah Azza wa Jal has our best interests at heart. We believe in Allah Azza wa Jal. We believe that Allah Azza wa Jal has a plan. We believe that even when it looks like there is no out, when it looks like it could not get any worse, when it looks like we are in a state of absolute despair, we know that Allah Azza wa Jal has a good plan for us. And that we are going through this with some exit strategy that we might not know. With something that is going to make us better in some way. And so this is one of the axioms, this is one of the most important things that we must have etched into our hearts, etched into our heads. Every single time. Every single time we are afflicted and faced with calamity, with trepidation, we must remember that Allah Azza wa Jal does not just do anything abatha. We must remember. we must bring back forth into our memory, make it very crystal clear that Allah Azza wa Jal tests those whom He loves. That is the reality. So whatever we are going through, the point is, it is to elevate us. That is the whole point. These tests are nothing more than a way for us to elevate higher. That's what they are. They are stairs, they are escalators. That's what they are. And a true mu'min sees them for what they really are. A true mu'min, someone who believes in Allah Azza wa Jal, someone who has complete tawakkul on Allah Azza wa Jal, understands this point. Completely internalizes this point. That truly, truly, everything is in Allah Azza wa Jal's hands. And so what we see, for example, in great feats of belief, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam tested thoroughly. Even Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, and we tested Ibrahim thoroughly, and he passed with flying colors, Allah Azza wa Jal says. وَإِذَ بِتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ بِكَلِمَاتٍ فَأَتَمَّهُنْ. أَتَمَّهُنْ means perfected it, aced the tests. And what we see is in Ibrahim alayhi salam, he has an unshakable faith. Unshakable faith. They're literally about to throw him in the fire. He says, Hasbi Allahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah Azza wa Jal is all I need. Allah Azza wa Jal handles all of my affairs. I have nothing to worry about. I want you to imagine being this young. In some there, in some of the Mufassirin, what they say is he was around 14 years old at the time. I want you to imagine being a 14-year-old or a 15-year-old, something like that. And having your father on the side of the prosecution, no less. Having your own family on the side of the persecution, and what you're seeing is they are preparing a fire for him that has been heated over days. And they're heating it, and they're heating it, and they're heating it. And Ibrahim, all he says, Hasbi Allahu wa ni'mal wakeel, Allah Azza wa Jal, you are completely handling my affairs. I have full faith in you, Allah Azza wa Jal. And they throw him into this fire. And all Allah Azza wa Jal has to do, all Allah Azza kuni bardan wa salam, be nice and gentle and breezy. Subhanallah. Ibrahim then walks into what is basically a garden, a beautiful, fragrant even, soft, comfortable Jannah, a sort of garden. Allah Azza wa Jal is in control always and forever. And if we have that steadfast in our heads, in our minds, then we will not lose faith, that we will not lose track of what is real and what isn't. At the end of the day, Allah Azza wa Jal, all He has to say is kun fayakun. And when Allah Azza wa Jal tests us and we remember that this is in a state, this is to test me and to make sure that I'm elevated, that I'm a better Muslim, that we come out as a better community, not just personally, but even as a group, that we all elevate together. If that is in the center of our head, if that's in the center of our attention, then we can then make that hadith a reality. عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ. Indeed, what an amazing state that a believer is in. What an astounding, amazing state. When they are hit with calamity, when they are tested, they say, Alhamdulillah. They say, Alhamdulillah. And when they are given benefit, when Allah Azza wa Jal gives them gifts, they say, Alhamdulillah. In both states, they thank Allah Azza wa Jal for whatever state they may be in. And in both states, they are rewarded. That is the most amazing thing. And so, by keeping Allah Azza wa Jal and Allah Azza wa Jal's plan in our head, what we are doing is saying, Tawakkaltu alayka ya Rabb. What we are saying is, I delegate all my affairs to you, Allah Azza wa Jal, for even if I was to handle my own affairs, and who could possibly want to do better for their own selves than their own selves? Wallahi, there is one, Allah Azza wa Jal. If we were to handle our own affairs as best and as diligently as we possibly could, we wouldn't be able to do what Allah Azza wa Jal could do for us. And so this is what tawakkul means. This is what putting our entire faith and our whole being in the hands of Allah Azza wa Jal, that is what the fruit may look like. And so what we must remember is constantly put this at the forefront of our head. Put that at the forefront of all of our thoughts. Because at the end of the day, this is how we calm ourselves. This is how we calm our hearts. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين. these stories that we hear about the Rusul and even the Sahaba who had great resolve and great faith in Allah Azza wa Jalla. They didn't stop with the Sahaba. To this very day, wallahi, and I know, you know, a lot of us are not Arabic speaking, so we might not be able to see this, and perhaps there's translation, so maybe some of us can look it up and find them. But what you'll find, for example, in what happened in Sheikh Jarrah, just a couple of weeks before that, subhanAllah, we're jumping from tragedy to tragedy to tragedy, subhanAllah. What we're seeing there, wallahi, I saw a mother of seven, or something like that, a big number of children, mashallah. And wallahi, she was in tears, happy, with a big smile. I've never seen anything like this in my whole life. She's crying tears of joy. She's saying, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, all of my children, they died as martyrs, as shuhada. I want you to imagine what this mother is feeling for. I want you to imagine, for those of you who have children, what all the tireless nights look like. The first night you hold your child, and you look him in the eye, the first time you hear Baba or Mama, the first time you take them to school, the first time they eat, the first time they play, the first time they say their first words, the first time you hear them saying, Allahu Akbar. The first time you hear them reciting the Qur'an, Ya Allah. All the joys and all these memories. And then I want you to multiply that by seven. And then I want you to have all your dreams, all the possible things that you want for them. And you dream that they're going to have a better life than you. And you're going to do so much for them to make sure that they have a better starting point than you ever did. And then having all of that ripped away in a second. And then I want you to look back at this lady. This beautiful, beautiful mu'mina. Who says, Alhamdulillah. Not like the Alhamdulillah that you and I say. Not the Alhamdulillah where we're like, yeah, yeah, Alhamdulillah. How are you doing, brother? Alhamdulillah. I got into an accident. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah. It's okay. Alhamdulillah. Not that same Alhamdulillah. She's crying tears of joy, brothers and sisters. Of joy. She's saying, Alhamdulillah, Allah Azza wa Jalla. He could have picked anybody, but he picked my children. She's so proud. He picked my children to be shuhada. He picked my children to get into Jannah. That's how she thinks. This is how she thinks. And she says, my only wish is that he had picked me with them so that I may be entered into Jannah with them. Allahumma ajma'aha ma'hum ya Rabb. This truly is the state of a mu'min. This truly, this is it. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبُ وَاللَّهِ الْعَظِيمُ. Indeed, with the mention of Allah Azza wa Jal, our hearts are calmed. Because the reality is, all that gives us this trepidation and anxiety, this feeling that, oh my God, this thing and that thing and this thing and that thing, all it is we feel like we are not in control, and the reality is we are not in control. And so if we can just embrace that we are truly not in control, embrace that there is someone else that is in control that can do way better than we ever could, the reality is we would be calm, brothers and sisters, we would be calm. We would have nothing to worry about. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, Alam nashrah laka sadrak. Have we not expanded your chest? When you felt it tighten, and you felt like the whole world is closing in, you felt like, you know, for us, for example, we're seeing Islamophobia on the rise, and it is in a rapid, rapid acceleration. We see it. We all have been seeing it. We've been witnessing it for the last couple of years. And the reality is, Allah Azza wa Jalla tells the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, who's dealing with far worse than we ever did, Alam nashrah laka sadrak. Have we not expanded your chest? When you had this difficulty, when you felt like the whole world is closing in, like your own family doesn't even believe you. Family that you want to enter into Jannah. All you want for them is to enter into Jannah. And so you worry, and you worry, and you say, oh, maybe if I say it this way, maybe if I deliver the message in this way, maybe then they can expect, I'm trying to save you. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, أَلَمْ نَشْرَحْ لَكَ صَدْرَكَ وَوَضَعْنَا عَنْكَ وِزْرَكَ. And we relieved you of this massive burden that's on your shoulder. وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ. And we have elevated you. We have elevated you in ways that you could not possibly believe. Today, how many Muhammads are there in the world? How many times is his name mentioned beside, alongside the name of Allah Azza wa Jalla? What great honor. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, he says, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. And the fa here to feed the surah. Fa, when Allah Azza wa Jalla says fa something, that means there's speed, there's expediency happening. And Allah Azza wa Jalla says, فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Indeed, truly with one calamity, the calamity, one singular, there is yusr, plentiful yusr, insurmountable yusr, ease. And then again, Allah Azza wa Jalla repeats it again. فَإِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. Forgive me. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. And so again, indeed, truly, with difficulty, with the difficulty, the one singular, the difficulty, plenty of yusr. This is Allah Azza wa Jalla's contract with us. This is Allah Azza wa Jalla's promise with us. What Allah Azza wa Jalla is saying, تَوَكَّلْ عَلَيْهِ. All you have to do is put your reliance on me. Delegate your affairs to me. I will handle it. Don't you worry. Don't worry. Don't fret about the small things. Don't make it your concern. Do your best. Ask Allah Azza wa Jal and He will get you there. That's the contract. And it is a very simple and relieving contract that we have with Allah Azza wa Jal. It is a contract that actually asks us to do less. We're worrying and we're doing and we're acting. Just calm down. Rely on Allah Azza wa Jal. And therein is a message. And the message is we must accept the qadr of Allah Azza wa Jal. We must accept the past. Whatever Allah Azza wa Jal has decided to happen will happen. There is nothing that can stop it. مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ كَانْ وَلَمْ يَشَأْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. At the end of the day, what Allah Azza wa Jal wills will happen. There is no doubt that you can't stop it. It's unstoppable. And what Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't want to happen will not happen. You can make it happen. You can put the seed in the soil, water it, sun, the whole nine. Nothing will grow. If Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't want it to grow, it won't grow. It's simple. And so the first thing we must understand is we must accept the qadr. Must accept that Allah Azza wa Jal has done this and that there is a plan and that this is for my benefit somehow. I might not see it now, but maybe someday He will reveal it to me. And the second thing to note is we can accept the qadr and stay at home. Did the Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, when he got this message, when this message was revealed to him, when this great responsibility was given to and given to him, did he stay at home and wait for the Sahaba to come and congregate so that he may give them the message, or did he go out? Or did he put a lot of effort and put himself into danger many, 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 many tens, if not hundreds, if not thousands of times? How many times? What does this tell you? Allah Azza wa Jalla says this many, many times in the Quran. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Those who believe and did good. They are together, they're one and the same. It is not enough that I accept the qadr, believe in Allah Azza wa Jal, and say, oh Allah Azza wa Jal, take the wheel. خلاص, I'm just going to sit here. No, no. Allah Azza wa Jal might help us direct, sure. But our job is to do the work. We have to do the work. We absolutely, 100% have to do the work. And so there is a lot, and the good thing is there's a lot of work for us to do. There's a lot of opportunities for ajr for every single one of us. Every single one of us is capable of something. We all have unique skill sets. But united, we can accomplish so much more. And so what we must do is look around us. Look at what efforts already exist. There are organizations, for example, like the NCCM. Look at what they are doing. They are protecting us and they are trying to put in effect legislation that would make this kind of act a criminal act. Islamophobia, a criminal act. Just like others are shielded from this kind of attack, and in the Canadian code it is criminalized, so too should Islamophobia. Just a few years ago, we had a similar motion come into the parliament, and it was actually denied, subhanAllah. And so some of the same people that denied it are now saying, oh, you know, we actually do believe in Islamophobia after all. And it costs our brothers. That's what it costs. And so we must not keep paying the price with our blood, brothers. We must not keep paying the price with our blood. What we must pay the price with is with our actions and hard work. And so support these organizations. Go out and see what they're doing and help. Wallahi, you can help. Don't feel like, oh, who's a little old me? Little old me is not incapable. Allah Azza wa Jal has tasked each and every single one of us with something. And so use it to the best, to the utmost of your ability. And we must not become numb to it. We hear it in the news so often that perhaps, you know, our hearts, they start to have layers of callous. That's what happens. You know, you open the news one day and it's like, X number of children in Palestine. Next morning, X number of children, you know, family in wherever it may be. next day. Some other shooting in somewhere. Some run over in some this other place. Even it doesn't have to be death even. You know, this family was just going to a park and they got beat up. And so on and so forth. Islamophobia is on the rise and we see it. And so we can't just sit here and wait. I can't just call myself Mo and act like I'm not Muslim, you know, just on the outside and escape it. You're not going to escape it. It's inescapable. These people are your family, they are our family, we are all brothers. And this is what makes this faith such a beautiful and amazing faith. Because it doesn't matter what the color of your skin is. It doesn't matter if you're male or female. It doesn't matter what you are. At the end of the day, you are my brother and I'm yours. And we stand for each other's rights. That's what we do. And so at the end of the day, we must take action. Talking is not enough. When we hear our politicians, they come in and say, "Assalamu alaikum, brother, I appreciate it, thank you. It's a nice gesture, but I need way more. I need way, way, way more." We need equality and justice for our people just like we do for everybody else. And we must stand up to injustice regardless. Not just for Muslims, by the way. For anybody with faith or no faith, it doesn't matter. Nobody deserves to be walking down the street and be mowed like this. No, nobody deserves that. And so we must stand up for what is right. No matter who the perpetrator is, and no matter who the victim is. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He says, "Unsur akhaka zaliman aw mazluman." Stand up to your brother or for your brother, be it they transgressed or they have been transgressed upon. And so therein you see that Islam, all it is about is our role in Islam is to stand up for justice. It doesn't matter which side. Stand up for justice. Just remember that, brothers and sisters. And if you feel like you cannot, at least donate some money. Support some of these causes. And if you feel like you don't have enough, then at least pray. Then at least ask Allah Azza wa Jal to effect change in this beautiful country of ours. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وذكر الله أكبر وبعد المصطفى الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله على ما أعطينا اللهم لك الحمد على ما أعطيتنا لك الحمد على ما أخذت منها يا رب لك الحمد على كل شيء لك الحمد أولا وآخرا وأبدا اللهم ربنا صلي وسلم وزد وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد اللهم ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وارحمنا واجعلنا من الصالحين اللهم اجعل عائلة الأفضل من الشهداء رب العالمين اللهم اكتبهم من الشهداء وادخلهم أعلى جناتك اللهم ارزقنا الجنة معهم يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وأقم الصلاة